Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about the advantage disadvantage of two systems, that is NTSC and PAL system. Along with this, we are also going to cover the difference between NTSC and PAL system. We know that in world, two power line frequencies are available, and they are 50 Hz and 60 Hz. So based on the power line frequency, definitely there are two different television standards appear. One operates with a frequency of 60 Hz and provide frame rate of 30 frames per second, and other operates with a frequency of 50 Hz and provide frame rate of 25 frames per second. So depending upon the power line compatibility, the different television standards are nothing but the American standard, that is NTSC, that stands for National Television System Committee. The second is nothing but the German standard PAL, which stands for phase alternate line, and third is the French standard, that is SCCAM. So in this video, we are specifically going to talk about the advantages and disadvantages provided by NTSC and PAL system. So basically, NTSC is a system which is accepted by the countries which uses 60 Hz as a power line frequency. So the standard was originated in America, and it provides a better picture quality in case of video and closed circuit conditions. But there is a problem with the NTSC standard, that there will be a color variation when the NTSC standard used in the broadcasting environment or open environment. So let's understand the advantages and disadvantages provided by NTSC system. So first of all, the high frame rate, that as it provides a frame rate of 30 frames per second because it uses a frequency of 60 Hz. So because of that, there will be a reduction in the flickering effect. So reduced visible flicker is considered as one of the most important advantage of the NTSC system. So let's move to the next advantage, and that is nothing but less inherent picture noise that results into the better signal to noise ratio. The simple circuit as compared to PAL and SCCAM. The next advantage is easy studio mixing is possible with the help of NTSC system, and it is less costlier as compared to the PAL system. Now let's move on to the disadvantage. The first disadvantage is small luminance signal bandwidth, which is approximately equals to 3.38 MHz and which increases the chances of interference. Then the second disadvantage is it is susceptible to the hue fluctuation. That means there will be a change in the color of picture when we use NTSC system in the open environment or in the broadcasting environment. The next disadvantage is lower gamma ratio, which is of 2.2, as the gamma ratio provided by the PAL system is 2.8. The next disadvantage is it is most costly as compared to the French standard, that is SCCAM. Then the last disadvantage is lower number of scan lines means reduce the quality of large TV screen. So basically, as the frames per second, or we can say the number of lines are less, which affects the quality of picture on the large screen. So these are the disadvantages provided by the NTSC system. Now let's move on to the PAL system. So in order to overcome the drawback, or in order to overcome the disadvantage of NTSC system, a modified version of NTSC system comes into the picture, that is nothing but the PAL system, which stands for phase alternate line. In NTSC system, the color of picture or hue is get changed in the open environment or in the broadcasting environment. So by shifting the color subcarrier phase, it is possible to avoid the hue changing problem occurs in NTSC system. And the modified version of NTSC is called as PAL, that is phase alternation line. So let's see the various advantages provided by PAL system. The first advantage is large number of scan lines, therefore more picture details is used, or more picture details are get provided on the screen. The PAL system also uses a frequency of 60 Hz. The next advantage is wider luminance signal bandwidth, which is approximately equals to 4.43 MHz. Then it provides stable hue because due to the error correction by the phase alteration, as the phase is get shifted in the picture subcarrier, because of that the hue variation problem is get avoided, and it provides the stable value of hue. Then the next advantage is higher gamma ratio, which is of 2:8, and therefore higher level of contrast as compared to NTSC system, and easy studio mixing, which is very easy or simple as compared to SCCAM. Now let's move on to the disadvantages of the PAL system. The first disadvantage is costlier receivers required because of the complex electronic circuitry or complex electronic switching methods. Then low frame rate and hence flicker occurs on into the picture. Then lower signal to noise ratio as compared to NTSC and variable color saturation. That means cancelling out phase difference by alteration holds hue stable, but at the same time it can changes the color saturation. That means when we add a phase shift into the subcarrier of the picture, the hue is get stable, but the color is get saturated. So these are the disadvantages related to the PAL system. Now let's move on to the comparison between PAL system, NTSC system along with the SC cam. So on the basis of various parameters like number of lines, frame rate, we are going to distinguish between the NTSC, PAL and SC cam. So the first parameter is nothing but the development or adaptation. So NTSC is developed by America, that is US. The PAL system is developed, is considered as a European standard, and SC cam is developed in France. Then the number of lines in NTSC, 525 lines are used. In PAL and SC cam, number of lines becomes 625 frames per second. In NTSC it uses 60 frames per second, whereas PAL and SC cam uses 50 frames per second. Then color information transmission, in NTSC U and V or I and Q are used, whereas in PAL U and V are used, whereas in SC cam DB or DR are used. Now let's move on to the next parameter, that is nothing but the subcarrier frequency. So the subcarrier frequency for NTSC is 3.58 megahertz, and in case of PAL it is 4.43 megahertz, whereas in case of SC cam it is 4.25 or 4.44 megahertz. So on the basis of subcarrier frequency, we will come to know that the frequency, that is subcarrier frequency used or provided by the NTSC system, is the lowest as compared to the PAL and SC cam. Now next is nothing but the color burst. The 9 cycles of subcarrier frequencies are used by NTSC system. PAL uses 10 cycles of subcarrier frequency, and in SC cam burst cycles of red and blue subcarrier frequencies are used. Now next is nothing but variant. Variants provided by NTSC systems are 4.43 J and M. In PAL system it is B, D, G, H, I, N, M and NC, whereas in SC cam it is B, G, D, K, K1 and L. Now cost, from cost wise NTSC is cheaper, whereas PAL is most costlier as compared to SC cam, and SC cam is the least expensive. Now next is the studio mixing. In case of NTSC it is very easy to perform a studio mixing, and in case of PAL it is medium, or we can say it is not that much complex as compared to SC cam, but it is not that much easy also as compared to NTSC system. And the studio mixing in case of SC cam is the most difficult one. So these are the certain parameters on the basis of which we can differentiate between the three standards used in the television system. So I hope you understand the advantage disadvantage of NTSC and PAL system along with their comparison with SC cam. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.